Welcome to our second article in the Marketing Cloud Connect series. This is about the subscriber key migration. So the subscriber key migration is really important for organizations that already have Sales or Service Cloud set up, as well as Marketing Cloud, or for any organization that might have a business workflow in which you would have people added to Sales Cloud or Marketing and Marketing Cloud separately. So they're not synced up the way that Marketing Cloud Connect is assuming they would be. This right here is an example of kind of what that's going to result in. We essentially have duplicates here. So an individual with the same email address, one contact, but two subscriber keys. This can be a problem for a variety of reasons. As you can see right here, this individual has unsubscribed, but it's only been applied to one of their subscribers. Not ideal. There's an additional problem with this. Without a migration in place, we do stand to lose data if I decide to just delete this one. So I'll show you what that kind of looks like. I have over here this test dedupe extension that's just got some basic information, and this is linked on email address right now. So this is something that we will change later because that's not ideal, as we're going to talk about later. But if I just delete this subscriber, eventually what's going to happen, and we'll check back in on this in a second, is that it's actually going to delete the subscriber in that data extension, in the target data extension. So obviously this isn't ideal for two reasons. Number one, we've just lost data that we may have wanted because this process, if you delete a subscriber, it will delete all the related information to any data extensions that are linked based on the subscriber relationship. It's just going to delete everything. It's just going to clear it all out. The other problem that we now have is that this person is still not unsubscribed, so I would have to manually unsubscribe them, and that's not ideal either. So what we want to do here is make sure that we have a process in place that's going to account for all of those things, minimize our data loss. And the very first thing that we're going to do here is actually make sure that our connection to the subscriber is correct, because email to subscriber key is not great. What we really should be using as a standard is subscriber key to subscriber key. And that's going to make sure that all of our connections are good and that we can actually use those Salesforce or the Sales Cloud or Service Cloud IDs as the connection and not just being reliant on email address, which is something that you have a tendency to do in Marketing Cloud, because we're not using those internal IDs for anything until we connect with Marketing Cloud Connect. So this is a very simple example of an automation you could set up to actually perform a subscriber key migration. The first step here is an SQL query that's actually going to collect information about the duplicates that you have, including all of the information we're going to need to actually perform the subscriber key migration. The second piece is the SSJS script that's going to do the bulk of the heavy lifting. The first thing that SSJS is going to do is go loop through all of the sendable data extensions that we want to retain data for that subscriber, and switch their subscriber key from the old subscriber key, which is often going to be the Marketing Cloud key, probably an email address, to the Sales or Service Cloud ID that's appropriate for that contact. Once we've done that, we can go about actually deduplicating. We can delete the duplicate subscriber, which in this case would actually be the Marketing Cloud subscriber. We're going to retain the Sales or Service Cloud subscriber, so we have that ID. And when we do that, since we have switched over the sendable data extensions, it's not going to delete that related information. It's going to retain it. One option that you can include in this process is retaining the subscription status of the subscriber that is being deleted. So if you have somebody who is unsubscribed, you could carry that through to the Sales or Service Cloud subscriber. You don't have to do that if it's not appropriate for your organization. You may just make the determination that you just don't want those Sales or Service Cloud IDs carried over at all because that person is unsubscribed. To run this is pretty simple. You can set up a schedule, or you can also just run this one time. I'm going to go ahead and do that for our guy right here. and we'll come back and see what happens. So now that the subscriber key migration process has run, we're going to check back in on our data extension here. You can see that we do have a line of data. It has not been deleted, and actually the subscriber key has changed. So because we have that set up, so it's subscriber key to subscriber key, this line is going to get retained. It's not going to get deleted. And if we check back into our all subscribers here, we no longer have duplicates, and we've retained the subscriber status from the marketing cloud contact into the sales cloud contact. So we're all good to go there. You can ultimately make the decision not to include sales cloud or service cloud contacts who have a linking, you know, contact in marketing cloud who are unsubscribed. That's up to you, and it depends on what your business workflow is like. But this is a method that we can use to retain that data ultimately. Using a subscriber key migration is a great solution to fully being able to leverage the tools that Marketing Cloud Connect offer you. Especially as we've discussed, if you're an organization who already has Sales or Service Cloud set up, as well as Marketing Cloud, it'll help ensure that you don't have duplicate contacts or subscribers and all subscribers, and also make sure that we can better retain the data from those duplicates when we eventually want to get rid of them and condense down into a single contact. One of the things that this process will also allow to do is something we'll discuss in our next article, which is actually passing data back from Marketing Cloud to Sales or Service Cloud. This process can be a little bit complex or involved in getting set up. Oftentimes, especially for existing organizations who have Marketing Cloud set up, there could be a lot of things to consider. So if you would like help setting up a marketing subscriber key migration for your Marketing Cloud, please feel free to reach out to us, and we'd be more than happy to assist you.